ripoffs and to avoid catastrophe. And now today's national investigative correspondent has a new book out, Rawson to the Rescue. Perfect for every emergency. Jeff joins us now. Jeff, just before we get started, the fires out in California have been devastating. You've actually done a lot on fire safety and how to escape disasters. Yeah. Any thoughts on that?
In this book, we have a lot of tips about how to handle fires, fire emergency plans, the fact that children sleep through smoke alarms. So I tell everybody in the country, whether you're in the wildfire zone or not, to have a fire escape plan and wake your children up because they won't wake up during fire alarms. If you live in the wildfire zone, we're seeing the video of that devastation right now. Here are a few things you want to do for your house. A, clean your roof and gutters. That's very important because that is kindling. That's the stuff. A leaf catches fire and then your home is up in flames. Something else, connect your garden hose and make sure it's long enough to reach every single area of your house. Weirdly, even inside your house. You'd never normally do that, but in a wildfire like this, you'll want to do that as well.
So if you live close enough to the zone, you have to be thinking about those things.
And also, 30 feet around your house should be no kindling, no dry wood, no plant life, anything like that.
Now, let me ask you, there's something called a pink tax that we're apparently paying. Explain what that is, because you get into this in the book.
Yeah, so switching gears, it's called the pink tax because women are paying much more money every single year for the bare essentials
like
than men.
Like what?
Thousands of dollars more a year, believe it or not. So, okay, so shaving cream, for example.
Yes.
Men's shaving cream, we went shopping, and this is what we found. Men's shaving cream goes for $2.29 in the store. Same brand, just the female version with the nicer, you know, soap to females, $2.39. 10 cents more.
Because it's pink.
But how? Just because it's pink. Right? 10 cents more. It doesn't sound like a lot, but how much shaving cream do you buy? There are a lot of legs to shave.
Well, it adds up. It adds up if they're getting you on the shampoo and the conditioner,
too.
So
here's the shampoo, right? Here's the shampoo right here. $3.99 for men. $4.79 for women. Same brand.
That's ridiculous.
Same brand.
But does it smell? I mean, the women's tends to smell pretty.
I don't smell good?
I don't know. Man smells are like musky.
No, it's actually the same active ingredients. We went and checked that as
well. And deodorant, too?
Here's deodorant. $3.89 for men. Again, this is the same brand we're comparing. $4.89 for women with the same active ingredient. And I have one more example to show
you. So we have to buy the men's version.
You're getting to my tips first?
Sorry.
Okay, fine.
Sorry.
I'll do that now, I guess.
Sorry.
Yes. So, okay. So
short on time.
So men's shirt to go get dry cleaned, $2.50. Women's shirt, I mean, feel the fabric. It's the same, okay?
Yeah, same.
Female shirt, $5 to get dry cleaned.
Yeah.
Double. So that is the tip. And you're very, very smart, Megan. You should do this more often. you should have a show.
I'm not surprised about this, right?
Women should buy the men's products. They work just as well. The active ingredients are the same.
What do I say to my dry cleaner?
There's nothing you can do about that.
Yeah. I'm just going to have my husband bring it in. Okay, so we're going to talk about coffee, because how many of you have spent like $4 for, you know, a Starbucks? Sorry.
Yep. Hey, guys.
Some sort of fancy coffee versus deli.
Yeah. So we're talking about expensive coffee.
Welcome.
This is Matt, right?
Hi, I'm Matt.
Allison?
Allison. Nice to meet you.
Okay, well, where are you guys from?
I'm from New York.
I'm from St. Louis.
Okay, so there's expensive coffee in both those towns, right? Okay, so cheap versus expensive coffee. Do you guys buy expensive coffee?
Yes.
I do.
Expensive,
too much.
Expensive. Yeah, because it's all marketing, right? It's sort of where your friends go. It's like the hip thing to do. We don't go to those deli carts or the deli. So we are comparing coffee, and we have a blind taste test here. In one of these cups is $1 coffee from the deli. In the other one is a cup of very, very fancy coffee that's $3.75. Okay. I want you to tell me which one you like better. So let's try this one first. Try the blue cup first.
Blue cup first.
Nervous.
Just tell me which one you like better. Which one tastes better? Don't reserve charge. So what does that taste like to you?
It's pretty good.
Not good.
Not good?
I don't like it. It's too bitter. It's too bitter for me.
Yeah, okay. Now try the yellow cup. And by the way, we did a test on this while you're drinking and you're...
That's the one for me.
Very complicated palates they have, apparently. 67%, we did a blind coffee taste test, chose the cheap stuff. So tell me which one they prefer. 67% chose the $1 cup. So which one do you guys like better, yellow or blue?
I think I'm going to go yellow.
Yellow?
Yellow.
Oh, yeah, yellow.
$1 coffee.
Yes.
$1 coffee.
I am not surprised. I am not surprised.
So buy the cheap stuff.
I love deli coffee in New York. You cannot go wrong. And the guy, when he serves it to you, will call you dear. Makes you feel happy. Get an egg and cheese on a roll. You'll be a happy person. Great to see you both. Thank you. Thank you, Rawson. Buy the book, Rawson to the Rescue. It's out right now. Highly recommend it.
Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there. And click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.